వక్రతుండమకాకాయ సూర్యకోటి సమప్రభ నిర్విఘ్నం కురు మే దేవ సర్వకార్యేషు సర్వదా. సరస్వతి నమస్తుభ్యం వదదే కామరూపిణి విద్యారంభం కరిష్యామి సిద్ధిర్ భవతు మే సదా. గురవే సర్వలోకానాం విశుచే భవరోగిణాం నిధయే సర్వ విద్యానాం దక్షిణామూర్తయే నమః. ఈశ్వరో గురురాత్మేతి మూర్తిభేద విభాగినే వ్యోమవత్ వ్యాప్త దేహాయ దక్షిణామూర్తయే నమః. శ్రుతిస్మృతిపురాణానాం ఆలయం కరుణాలయం నమామి భగవత్పాదం శంకరం లోకశంకరం. సదాశివసమారంభాం శంకరాచార్యమధ్యమాం అస్మదాచార్యపర్యంతాం వందే గురు పరంపరాం. సాక్షాత్కృతం దయానందం పరమార్థస్వరూపిణం తత్వజ్ఞాన ప్రశాస్తారం ప్రణతోస్మి పరం పదం. ఓం సహనాభవతు సహనౌ భునక్తు సహ వీర్యం కరవావహై తేజస్వినావధీతమస్తు మా విద్విషావహై. ఓం శాంతి శాంతి శాంతిః. ఓం పార్థాయ ప్రతిబోధితాం భగవతా నారాయణేన స్వయం వ్యాసేన గ్రథితాం పురాణమునినా మధ్యే మహాభారతం అద్వైతామృతవర్షిణీం భగవతీం అష్టాదశాధ్యాయినీం అంబత్వామనుసంధామి భగవద్గీతే భవద్వేషినీం. నమోస్తుతే వ్యాసవిశాలబుద్ధే పుల్లారవిందాయతపత్రనేత్ర ఏన త్వయా భారతతైలపూర్ణః ప్రజ్వాలితో జ్ఞానమయః ప్రదీపః. ప్రపన్నపారిజాతాయ తోత్రవేత్రైకపాణయే జ్ఞానముద్రాయ కృష్ణాయ గీతామృతదుహే నమః. సర్వోపనిషదో గావః దుగ్ధా గోపాలనందనః పార్థో వత్సః సుధీర్భోక్తా దుగ్ధం గీతామృతం అరత్. వసుదేవసుతం దేవం కంసచాణూరమర్దనం దేవకీ పరమానందం కృష్ణం వందే జగద్గురుం. భీష్మద్రోణతటా జయద్రతజలా గాంధారనీలోత్పలా శల్యగ్రాహవతీ కృపేణ వహనీ కర్ణేణ వేలాకులా అశ్వత్థామవికర్ణఘోరమకరా దుర్యోధనావర్తినీ సోత్తీర్ణా ఖలు పాండవైరణనదీ కైవర్తకకేశవః. పారాశర్యవచసరోజమమలం గీతార్తగంధోత్కటం నానాఖ్యానకకేసరం హరికథా సంబోధనాబోధితం. లోకే సజ్జన షట్పదైరగరగపీయమానం ముదా భూయాద్ భారత పంకజం కలిమల ప్రధ్వంసిన శ్రేయసే మూకం కరోతి వాచాలం పంగుం లంఘయతే గిరిం యత్కృపాత్తమహం వందే పరమానందమాధవం యం బ్రహ్మా వరుణేంద్ర రుద్రమరుతః స్తున్వంతి దివ్యైస్తవైః వేదైః సాంగపదక్రమోపనిషదైః గాయంతి యం సామగాః ధ్యానావస్థితతద్గతేన మనసా పశ్యంతి యం యోగినః యస్యాంతం న విదుస్సురాసురగణాః దేవాయ తస్మై నమః. నారాయణం నమస్కృత్య నరం చైవ నరోత్తమం దేవీం సరస్వతీం వ్యాసం తతో జయముదీరయేత్. We can chant the shloka, second chapter, 11th shloka. You can repeat after me. Ashochyananvashochastvam
Ashochyananvashochastvam
Prajñavadamscha bhashase గతాసూనగతాసూంశ్చ నానుశోచంతి
పండితా.
We are reading, studying the introduction to this shloka, 11th shloka of the second chapter, from where the teaching of Bhagavan starts. To that shloka, Bhagavad Pada has written a short commentary. So before the teaching of Bhagavan starts, Bhagavad Pada, he gives the base for the teaching, because the teaching being Jnanam, Jnanopadesha. So therefore Bhagavad Pada, he gives an introduction to that shloka, where Bhagavad Pada, he clearly states that for Jnanam, for Moksha, what is required is only Jnanam. No any other support is required for gaining moksha other than jnanam. Jnanam eva sakshat karanam. Because in those days, people were so deeply engaged in the karma part of the Vedas, karma kanda of the Veda. There were many schools of thought in those days, mainly the karma kandi. They are the main Purvapakshi, Purva Mimamsa, and other people who argued in favor of that for moksha you need jnanam along with karma. So karma played an important role in their pursuit. So to that Bhagavad Pada, to Bhagavad Pada, he had to dismiss the idea that jnana sahita karma sahita jnanam gives moksha. That idea Bhagavad Pada he had to dismiss. That is why in all his argument, what we have seen so far, Bhagavad Pada, he himself raises a doubt as though from the side of the Purvapakshi, the opponent, and dismisses. So Bhagavad Pada, what he does is, He criticizes the samuchaya, the synthesis, the combination of jnana and karma. For moksha, jnanam alone is required. Jnanena eva mokshaha. There is no combination of yogas. Like now the modern philosophy is some say that the combination of yogas gives moksha. You have to mix up all the yogas. Karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga, and other yogas are there. So you can combine all the yogas and attain moksha. But there is no combination possible. For moksha, sakshat karanam is only jnana. The problem being samsara and the root cause of the problem being ajnanam, ignorance, the solution can only be moksha. No karma can play an active role directly in gaining moksha. No karma and no any other yoga, Kundalini yoga or any yoga you say, they don't have any direct active role in giving moksha. So therefore, what we study now, it is with the discussion, the points which are clearly given by Bhagavad Pada in dismissing the Samuchayavadi, is also applicable to the modern thoughts, Vedanta, Neo-Vedanta philosophy. They have a peculiar philosophy. Without understanding what Vedanta is, what Shastram is, what Pramanam is, they propound a new philosophy, that combination of yogas and all. So this logic, what we studied and what we understood from the Bhashyam, helps us in clearly analyzing the modern philosophy also and dismissing it. So it gives a beautiful insight into what the Shastram says. Therefore, though we talk about karma and all, and in the modern times it is not applicable because many of us, we don't do many karma. But there are people who does karma. There are some traditional people who does karma even now. There are Agnihotris. They do Agnihotra karma daily. So there are some orthodox traditional people who does karma. They know what it is. But since majority of us, we don't do any karma, we don't follow the karma kanda part of the Veda, but still studying this Bhashyam, it gives an idea how karma was practiced, how it was practiced, how it was prevalent in those times. Those ideas we get from the Bhashyam. That is why the Bhashyam is important. We cannot dismiss the Bhashyam as, this part of the Bhashyam as irrelevant. We don't have such idea, but still I'm saying. Okay, with this small introduction, we'll continue with the discussion. Hoping that you remember the line of discussion. Line of discussion we studied in the previous classes. We saw the Bhashyam, which starts with Yasya tu ajnanat, which you can see in the screen point. That line we saw in the previous class and discussed in detail. You can repeat after me, we can chant those two vakyams. Yasya tu ajnanat.
Yasya tu ajnanat.
Ragadi doshataha.
Ragadi doshataha.
Vakarmani.
Vakarmani.
Yasya tu ajnanat. Ragadi doshataha. Vakarmani. That is how it should be read. Doshatava karmani pravrtasya.
Karmani pravrtasya.
Yajnena danena tapasava.
Yajnena danena tapasava.
विशुद्धसत्त्वस्य
विशुद्धसत्त्वस्य
ज्ञानम् उत्पन्नम्
ज्ञानम् उत्पन्नम्
परमार्थतत्त्वविषयम्
परमार्थतत्त्वविषयम्
एकमेव इदं सर्वम्
एकमेव इदं सर्वम्
एकमेव इदं सर्वं ब्रह्म
एकमेव इदं सर्वं ब्रह्म
ब्रह्म
अकर्तृ च इति
अकर्तृ च इति
इति
All of you can chant. If you don't want to chant with your mic unmute, you can chant with your mic in mute also. When you repeat after me, it's not chanting, it's a divakyam. When you repeat after me, so we are getting familiarity with this in reading the Bhashya. You know, now you are learning how to read the Bhashya. So, applying the Sandhi rules and all, we are trying to read the Bhashya. And Sanskritam is not much difficult. Little knowledge of Sanskritam, we can understand also. Tasya karmani.
Tasya karmani.
Karma prayojane cha.
Karma prayojane cha.
Nivritte api.
Nivritte api.
लोकसङ्ग्रहार्थम्
लोकसङ्ग्रहार्थम्
यत्र पूर्वं यथा प्रवृत्तिः तथैव प्रवृत्तस्य
तथैव प्रवृत्तस्य
यत् प्रवृत्तिरूपम् दृश्यते
दृश्यते
न तत् कर्म येन बुद्धेः समुच्चयः स्यात्
येन बुद्धेः समुच्चयः स्यात्
ओके यू कैन म्यूट नाउ सो वी हैव सीन दिस लाइन डिस्कस दिस लाइन इन डिटेल इन द प्रीवियस क्लास What does it say? The essence of these lines is a jnani can still do karma. A jnani, the one who has gained jnanam and therefore moksha, a muktaha, a mukta purushaha, he can still do karma after gaining atma jnanam. But the karma what he does is not really a karma. Here the karma can be a laukika karma or it could be a vaidika karma or any karma. When we say jnani, jnani need not be a sannyasi. It could be a sannyasi jnani or it could be a grihastha jnani. A person could be an householder, grihastha. The lifestyle could be a grihastha. That is also possible. Need not be only sannyasi. So, Grihastha Jnani can still do karma, Vaidika karma also, after gaining Atma Jnanam. You may ask, what is the use of those karma? Karma may not have any purpose to him, but still, he does to set an example for the people to follow. Or for the Loka Sangharatam, for the welfare of the people also, he can do. But the point is, the karma what he does is not really a karma. The karma what he does cannot be counted as karma. Why? To count something as a karma, there should be kartrutvam on the part of the person who does the karma. And here, for this jnani, there is no kartrutvam. Kartrutvam, the status of being a doership. Doership is not there for a jnani. If doership is there, then the person is not a jnani. Aham karta, that buddhi is not there for the jnani. Because his aham is not in the body, it's not in the mind, it's not in the senses. His aham is God, doesn't have the locus in this body, mind, sense complex. is agam is now as a locus in brahma ekam eva idam sarvam brahma akartu cha iti. Yes, look, the locus of agam, that I, is in brahma. Brahma is everything. Therefore, everything being myself, how can I do karma? How can I do karma? So, I am the one permeating the entire universe. Sarvam idam brahma, tat brahma agamasmi. Then how can I do karma? I cannot do karma on myself. To do karma, there must be subject-object. Karta must be there, karma must be there. And other karakas also required. In Sanskritam also we saw karakas. Other karakas are required for accomplishing an action. But for a jnani, there is no karta. Karta itself is not there. Then where is the kriya? Patati, when you say reading, who reads? Ramaha patati. Rama itself is not there. The identification for the person, Rama, that he is Rama, he is a son of so-and-so, and he is his body mentions complex, it is not there. Then where is the patati? But still he reads. That karma is not really a karma. That is what Bhagavad Pada says. The karma, what he does, is not really a karma. Because kartrutvam is not there. Therefore, since karta is not there for a jnani, therefore, all the karakas are not there. Only when karta is there, then karma will be there. The object of action will be there. Then karana, the instrument of action will be there. Sampradana, other karaka. Sampradana, sampradana karaka, apadana karaka, adhikarana karaka. All these karakas are possible only when karta is there. Because the action is done for the karta, by the karta. For himself he does, or for others he does. Without karta, there is no kriya possible. Therefore, since karta itself is not there, therefore there is no kartrutvam, no kartrutvam, no karakas. If karta is there, then the result of the action will come to that karta. Karta is also, karta itself is not there. Then the result also is not there. Therefore, karma doesn't affect him. So what he does is not a karma. That karma is mithya. It is not really karma. It is only a semblance of karma. Therefore, the karma palam also will not come to the jnani. The karma palam will not affect the jnani. Only when he does the karma, only when he does the karma, and that karma is the sense of doing a karma is possible only when kartrutvam is there. When kartrutvam itself is not there, therefore bhoktrutvam is also not there. So akam karta, that buddhi is not there. Akam bhokta, that buddhi is also not there for the jnani. Therefore, what the karma, what a jnani does is not really karma. But he does karma. We see that karma is only for loka sangrahartam. That is only for the welfare of the jnani. They don't create any impact in the jnani. Since that person is already a mukta, therefore, what is the need for him to do karma? Already is mukta. He has gained what is to be gained, achieved what is to be achieved. So therefore, the ultimate thing in life is what? Atmajnanam. The person is at home only when he has this jnanam. I am at myself. Then this jnanam is gained. The person has gained that. Once you have gained that, then what is the need for doing karma? Any karma you do, it has a motive. You do a certain karma to accomplish something. That is why we have four purushartha: dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Why it is called purushartha? Purushayi artyate. That is sought by the human beings. I want a dharma, therefore I do certain action. I want artha, money. I want kama, I want to enjoy certain pleasures, therefore I do karma. So there is a motive, there is a goal is there, artha is there, therefore arthi is there. But here, what is the artha for the jnani? He has already accomplished moksha. சதுர்வித புருஷார்த்தானாம் மோக்ஷக ஏவ பரம புருஷார்த்தக தட் இஸ் ஆல்ரெடி கெயின்ட். தேர்ஃபோர் தேர் இஸ் நோ பர்பஸ் ஃபார் அ ஜானி இன் டூயிங் தி கர்ம, பட் ஈ ஸ்டில் டஸ் கர்ம. ஃபார் வாட்? லோக்க சங்கிரகார்த்தம் கர்ம கரோதி. ஃபார் தி வெல்ஃபேர் ஆஃப் த பீப்புள், ஃபார் த பெனிஃபிட் ஆஃப் தி லோக்க த பீப்புள், and also to set an example for the people to emulate him, he does karma. And therefore, by seeing the karma in that person, we cannot conclude that person, that jnani, he combines jnanam and karma to gain moksha. No, he is not doing karma to gain jnanam. You have to understand, he is already a jnani, already a muktaha. Being muktaha, he does karma. Therefore, there is no ஞான கர்ம சமுச்சயா, தர் இஸ் நோ ஞான கர்ம சகபாவா. தி எக்ஸிஸ்டன்ஸ், தி கோ எக்ஸிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஞானம் அண்ட் கர்மா சைமல்டேனியஸ்லி இன் தி பர்சன் இஸ் நாட் சீன், இட்ஸ் நாட் தேர். தெர்ஃபோர் ஞான கர்ம சமுச்சயக நாஸ்தி இதி பகவத்பாத கிளியர்லி ஸ்டேட்ஸ் இன் திஸ் வாக்கியம்ஸ். ஹோப் யூ ஃபாலோ அப் திஸ். அப்டர் திஸ் தென் Bhagavad-pada, he continues. We will read that next line. Yatha Bhagavataha
Yatha Bhagavataha
Vasudevasya
Vasudevasya
Kshatradharma-cheshtitam
Kshatradharma-cheshtitam
Kshatradharma or Kshatradharma? Both are there.
Kshatra.
Both are there. No problem. It's okay. Kshatra. I'm saying both are there. Okay. Kshatra dharma cheshtitam.
Kshatra
dharma cheshtitam is there. Kshatra karma cheshtitam also is there. What a Veda are there. Ajnanena
Ajnanena
Tamuchyate
Tamuchyate
Purushartha siddhaye
Purushartha siddhaye
Purushartha அகங்கார அபாவஸ்ய துல்யத்வாத் விதுஷஃ. யதா பகவதஹ வாசுதேவஸ்ய க்ஷத்ர தர்ம சேஷ்டிதம் ந ஞானேன சமுச்சியதே புருஷார்த்த சித்தயே தத்வத் தத் பலாபிஸ்ஸந்தி அகங்கார அபாவஸ்ய துல்யத்வாத் விதுஷஹ. சோ நவ பகவத் பத ஹி கிவ்ஸ் தி உதாரணம் ஆஃப் பகவான் கிருஷ்ணா ஹிம்செல்ஃப் for the above statement. The above statement, he was talking about a jnani. A jnani, after gaining jnanam, he does karma for loka sangharartham. And the, as he was doing karma before, so he will do karma for loka sangharartham. Iti Bhagavad Pada, he mentioned about a jnani. Mentioned in general about jnani, jnanis. Here, Bhagavad Pada gives the example of Bhagavan himself. Bhagavan himself he gives. Bhagavan Krishna is a jnani. He is not just a sarathi of Arjuna. He is not just a friend of Arjuna. He is a sarathi. Sorry, he is not just a sarathi, he is a jnani. Though he was a jnani, he continued to do karma. He continued to do karma. And in the battlefield now he is driving the ratha of Arjuna. And therefore, because we observe karma in Krishna, it does a lot of it did a lot of karma. To avoid the yuddha also, it did a lot of work. And because we observe karma in Krishna, can we conclude that Bhagavan Krishna is doing jnana karma samuchaya? Was Bhagavan doing karma to gain jnana, or was he already a muktaha doing karma? If Bhagavan, if he is not a jnani, then he is not Bhagavan. Then we cannot have this objective Bhagavan Krishna. If it is a jnani, then Bhagavan Krishna. If it's a jnani and doing karma, then karma, what he does is not for the samuchaya. Therefore, Bhagavan is not doing jnana karma samuchaya. Already a mukta, he does karma. He didn't do karma to gain moksha. Therefore, the karma of Krishna is not karma at all. Because any karma you take, it must have two things. Number one, kartratva must be there. And number two, the karma is done for accomplishing any purushartha. It is meant for gaining any purushartha. It could be dharma, artha, kama or moksha. These two things must be there for doing any karma. Even if your daily life, if any karma you do, these things must be present. It must be there. Bhagavan Krishna doesn't have the kartratvam. Aham karta buddhi is not there for Bhagavan. No ahankara in him. Therefore, no kartratvam. And kartratvam is not there. And secondly, Bhagavan doesn't have to do karma to accomplish any purushartha. The ultimate purushartha, parama purushartha, mokshaha is already achieved. Therefore, no motive is there for the karma of Bhagavan. Therefore, the same thing can be extended to jnani also. The same thing can be extended to jnani also. Jnani also, like Bhagavan, it has karma. So therefore, that is what this line says. And in the line, you can see, Yatha bhagavataha vasudevasya kshatra dharma cheshtitam na jnanena samuchyate purushatta siddhaye tadvat tatpalabhisandhi akankara abhavasya prilyatvat vidushaha. Vidushaha means jnani. Vidushaha means jnani. Another word for jnani. It is from the shabda vidvas shabda. Sakaranta shabda vidvan. Vidvamsau vidvamsaha, vidvamsam vidvamsau vidushaha. And here vidushaha is shashti vibhakti, not dvitiya vibhakti bhagavachanam, shashti vibhakti, vidushaha, sakaranta shabda. So the line says, yatha bhagavataha tadvat vidushaha. You can see tadvat is that yatha bhagavataha tadvat vidushaha. What does it mean? As Bhagavan, so jnanis. As Bhagavan, so jnanis. What is that? Yatha bhagavataha vasudevasya cheshtitam kshatra dharma. Yatha bhagavataha vasudevasya cheshtitam kshatra dharma. Bhagavan is Vasudeva. Vasudevasya apatyam puman Vasudeva. The son of Vasudeva is Vasudeva. Vasudeva is Krishna's father. Vasudeva is Bhagavan Krishna. Bhagavataha is Shashti Bhakti and Vasudevasya also Shashti Bhakti. It's a visheshana. Bhagavataha Vasudevasya. Vasudevasya and he is Bhagavan. Bhagavataha Vasudevasya. Cheshtitam. Cheshtitam means kritam. Performed. Cheshtitam. Cheshta, kriya. Karma, kritam. He performed what? Kim cheshtitam? Kshatra dharma. Kshatra karma. Kshatra dharma or kshatra karma. Another part of Veda is the kshatra karma. What is kshatra or kshatra? Kshatra is kshatriyasya. Idam. That is, that belongs to Kshatriya. So, Kshatra Dharma, Kshatra, from word Kshatra, we get Kshatra, Tadita. So, Kshatra Karma, if the word is Kshatra Dharma, Kshatra Karma, then it is Kshatriya Karma. That is the Kshatriya Dharma. That is Kshatra Dharma. The duty of a Kshatriya. So, cheshtitam, kritam, performed, what? Kshatra dharma. Kshatriya karma, the karma, the dharma of a Kshatriya. What is that? What is the dharma of a Kshatriya? Dharma paripalanam. He has to protect the dharma, praja paripalanam. He has to protect the people. So, yatha bhagavataha vasudevasya karma, vasudevasya kshatra dharma cheshtitam. As Bhagavan Vasudeva is engaged in performing the duties of a Kshatriya. Vasudeva is a Kshatriya. Therefore, he is doing his dharma. Kshatriya dharma is doing. Yata, as he was doing, for what? Does he do karma to gain any purushartha? Purushartha siddhaye? Purushartha siddhaye kritam karma? Na. He already is muktaha. Purushartha-siddhaye na jnanena samuchyate. Purushartha-siddhaye for the accomplishment of the purushartha. Purushartha-siddhaye, chaturthi-bhakti, na samuchyate. Doesn't combine. What? Karma. Karma is not combined. Combined with what? Jnanena. So, Bhagavan, he does as a, he performs kshatriya dharma and doesn't combine with jnanam for the accomplishment of the purushartha. The kshatra karma of Bhagavan is not combined with jnanam for the accomplishment of purushartha, any purushartha. Any karma you do, you get punyam or papam. But Bhagavan is not touched by punyam or papam. Therefore, no purushartha siddhi is there for Bhagavan. Bhagavan already being a muktaha, what purushartha he needs to accomplish? Bhagavan himself, he says later, name partha stikartagyam trishilokeshu kinchana nana vapta navaptabhyam karma evacha vartha evacha karmani. The third chapter, 22nd shloka, he says, name partha stikartagyam, I don't have any karma to be done. To be done, karma is not there for me. In all the three worlds, Trishu Lokeshu, Kinchana, Karma, Kartavyam, Na. For me, it is not there. In all the three worlds, there is no karma to be done for me. Na, Nanavaptam Avaptavyam. Na, Anavaptam Avaptavyam. I don't have anything which is not yet gained, not gained. It means what? I have gained everything. Is muktaha, I'm a jnani. Therefore, there is no purushartha siddhi for Bhagavan. Therefore, purushartha siddhi jnanena kshatra karma, kshatra dharma na samuchyate. As Bhagavan's performance of kshatra karma is not combined with knowledge, jnanam, for the accomplishment of any purushartha, as it is in the case of Bhagavan, so tadvat, similarly, vidushaha karma jnanena na samuchyate. So too, the karma of jnani is not combined with jnanam. Yata bhagavataha tadvat vidushaha. Bhagavataha Cheshtitam kshatra dharma na jnanena samuchyate purushata siddhaye tadvat vidushaha. The same way for vidusha, jnani is also. How do you say that? As it is for Bhagavan, so it is for jnani. How do we say that? What is the base? What is the base to come to this conclusion? That is, in both of them, that is in Krishna and in jnani, there is absence of Palabhisandhi. There is absence of Palabhisandhi and Ahankara. Palabhisandhyahankara bhavasya is there. Palabhisandhyahankara bhava Ahankara bhavasya. There is absence of Palabhisandhi and Ahankara. Palabhisandhi Ahankara abhavasya. Palabhisandhi cha Ahankara cha Palabhi Sandhi Ahankarau Tayoga Abhavaha Tasya. Palabhi Sandhi means Paleshu Abhisandhi or Palaya Abhisandhi. Phala is result. Abhisandhi is it is attachment. It is longing for the result, desire for the karma phala. Abhisandhi. Sandhi is joining, connecting with the phala, karma phala. So desire for karma phala. Phala abhisandhi, desire for the karma phala. And ahankara. Ahankara is kartra buddhi, aham karta iti buddhi. Aham karta, aham bhokta. That kartrutvam and bhoktrutvam, that is called ahankara. These two things, that palabhisandhi and ahankara, both of them, abhavasya. Abhavasya vasudevasya. Abhavasya vidushaha. Both of them are not there in Bhagavan Vasudeva as well as in Jnani also. Jnani also it is not there. In Bhagavan also it is not there. Therefore, yata bhagavataha tadvat vidushaha katam palavisandhi akankar abhavasya tulyatvat. Because of the similarity, tulyatvat, similarity of the absence of palabhisandhi, that is the desire for the result of action, and ahankara, the kartrutva bhoktrutva buddhi, it is not there because of the absence of these two things. Vidushaka karma, the karma of a jnani also, jnanena na samuchyate, it is not combined with jnanam for gaining moksha. So therefore, yata bhagavataha tadvata vidushaha. After this, now the Bhashyakara, he quotes from the Gita itself. From the Gita itself to substantiate this point. The next line we can read.
Tattavit.
Naham karomi iti manyate.
Naham karomi iti manyate.
Nacha tat. Tatpalam.
Nacha tatpalam.
Abhisandhate. Okay, you can see this line. Tatvavit na aham karomi iti manyate. Nacha tatpalam abhisandhate. Karomi plus iti, karomi iti. Now, those are in basic samskrita, they know. Savarna dirgha sandhi. Karobiti. So, tattvavit. Tattvavit. What is tattvavit? Tattvam veti. Tattvam veti. Tattvam veti, tattvam janati. Iti tattvavit. Tattvam is the ultimate reality. Tattvam. Tattva bodha, we say. Tattva bodha is the knowledge of the reality. That is a tattvam. The one who knows the reality is called Tattvavit. Tattvam Veti Tattvam Janati. The one who knows the reality. Who is that? Jnani. So Tattvavit means what? Jnani. So Tattvavit, Jnani, Vidwan, all these are synonyms, same. So Tattvavit Manyate. Tattvavit, that is jnani, manyate, he recognizes, he appreciates. Manyate is the kriyapadam. Tattvavit is the karta. So tattvavit, manyate, tattvavit, he recognizes. What? He recognizes the fact that naham karomi iti. Na aham karomi. Na aham naham. Aham na karomi. I don't do what? I don't do any karma. Tattvavit manyate aham na karomi iti. The knower of the reality, he recognizes the fact that I don't do. Therefore, tatpalam na abhisandhate. Abhisandhate is a kriyapadam. Na should be connected to that. Na abhisandhate. Na abhisandhate. What? Tatpalam. Karmanaha palam. The result of the action na abhisandhate. Tattvavit na abhisandhate. He doesn't desire for the result of the action. Because అహం నా కించిత్ కరోమి బికాస్ ఐ డోంట్ డూ ఎనీ కర్మ దేర్ ఫోర్ ఐ డోంట్ డిజైర్ ఫర్ ద రిజల్ట్ ఆఫ్ యాక్షన్ ఓన్లీ వెన్ ఐ డూ యాక్షన్ ఐ షుడ్ ఎక్స్పెక్ట్ ది రిజల్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది యాక్షన్ ఐ డోంట్ డూ ఎనీ యాక్షన్ అహం కించిత్ నా కరోమి దెన్ హౌ క్యాన్ ఐ బి అటాచ్ టు ది కర్మ ఫలం దర్ ఇస్ నో డిజైర్ దర్ ఇస్ నో కర్మ ఫలం ఎక్స్పెక్టేషన్ పాసిబుల్ ఇట్ డజంట్ డిజైర్ ఫార్ ది రిజల్ట్ ఆఫ్ యాక్షన్ కర్తృత్వం బీయింగ్ నాట్ దేర్ దర్ ఫోర్ ఈస్ నాట్ డూయింగ్ ఎనీ కర్మ Therefore, he says, Aham na karomi kinchit. Aham karomi, aham karta, that buddhi is not there. Therefore, there is no desire for the result of action. Action itself is not there. Then how can be the desire for result of action? Therefore, aham na karomi. Aham na karomi, that phrase, it is there in the Gita itself. The Gita, 5th chapter, 8th and 9th shloka. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ ఈ బ్యూటిఫుల్లీ రిప్రజెంట్స్ ద తత్వ విత్ దట్ జ్ఞాని హౌ డస్ ద జ్ఞాని హీ థింగ్స్ రికగ్నైజెస్ హి అప్రిషియేట్స్ దిస్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ దట్ అహం న కరోమి ఇతి నైవ కించిత్ కరోమి ఇతి యుక్తో వన్యేత తత్వ విత్ ఇన్ ద శ్లోక ఇట్సెల్ఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ద నైవ కించిత్ కరోమి ఇతి దట్ కరోమి ఇతి నైవ తత్వ విత్ ద వర్డ్స్ ఆర్ దర్ సో భగవత్ పద ఈస్ కోటింగ్ directly from that shloka, 5th chapter of the Gita itself. Naiva kinchit karomiti yukto manyeta tattuvit pashyan shunvan spashan jigran ashtin gachan swapan shvasan pralapan visrajan grindan unmishan nimishan napi indriyan indriyarteshu vartanta iti dharayan. That is, the tattuvit, he recognizes a fact, akam kinchit na karomi iti. I don't do anything. Pashyan, seeing action, shrunvan, listening, spishan, touching, jigran, smelling, ashnan, eating, gachan, going. And all the activities, the jnani doesn't have the identification, the abhimana of agam karta, agam bhokta iti. Therefore, he doesn't do any karma and therefore no karma pala abhisandhi for the jnani. Okay, then continuing the next line. Yathacha Swargadi Kamarthinaha
Swargadi Kamarthinaha
Agnihotradi
Agnihotradi
Karma కర్మ లక్షణ ధర్మానుష్ఠానాయ
కర్మ ధర్మానుష్ఠానాయ
ఆహితాగ్నేహే
ఆహితాగ్నేహే
కామ్యేయేవ
కామ్యేయేవ
అగ్నిహోత్రాదౌ
అగ్నిహోత్రాదౌ
ప్రవృత్తస్య Samikrute, that is one word actually, that's not separate. Samikrute.
Samikrute.
Vinashte api.
Vinashte api.
Vinashte api. Kame.
Kame.
Tadeva.
Tadeva.
Agni otradi.
Agni otradi.
Anushtitaha.
అగ్నిహోత్రాది
This we have to discuss. It will take some time. Do you have class? Next class is there? Dakshinamurti Stotram? Is it there or? Anybody is there?
Okay. Yes. Yes, sir.
It is there in the evening.
Not there. Okay.
No, he cancelled it.
Okay, fine. We can continue then. It will take some time. 15 minutes it will take. ओके यथाच स्वर्गादि कामार्थिनः अग्निहोत्रादि कर्मलक्षण धर्म अनुष्ठानाय आहिताग्नेके काम्ये एव अग्निहोत्रादौ प्रवृत्तस्य सामीकृते विनष्टे अपि कामे तदेव अग्निहोत्रादि अनुतिष्ठतः अपि न तत् काम्यम् अग्निहोत्रादि भवति. यद् भगवत्पाद गिव्स् एन् एक्साम्पल् and example of what? Example of a karma itself to show it to the karmakandi, the purva mimamsa, the jnana karma samuchaya vadi, who strongly holds on to the view that jnana karma samuchaya is required for moksha. To them, Bhagavad-pada, he gives an example, an apt example. Bhagavad-pada, he talks to them in the same language. He gives the same example. Their example he gives. Karma example itself he gives to dismiss the point. To dismiss the jnana karma samuchaya. He gives an example of this agnihotradi karma. Agnihotradi, means agnihotra, etc. Other karmas are there. He takes that as an example and dismisses the point. Dismisses the jnana karma samuchaya. The view of the Purva Pakshi. Okay. So before discussing on this, we must know what are those karma, Agnihotradi karma. Agnihotra is a ritual. Agnihotra is a karma, it's a Nitya karma. It's a Nitya karma. It's a compulsory Vedika karma one must do. Who must do? A brahmachari cannot do. A brahmachari cannot do Agnihotra. It's not eligible. Why? For Agnihotra, you need a bharya. Brahmachari, how can he do? For brahmachari, sandhyavandanam, samitadhanam, brahmayakyam, those are nitya karma which he must do. Whereas, a brahmachari, after getting married, after becoming a grihastha, now he must perform a Nitya Agnihotra. That is the fire from the marriage, that Viraga Agni, that from the fire itself is taken and is preserved. And it is preserved and every day, morning two Agutis and evening two Agutis. He should give it to the fire. The ritual is very simple, but you have to maintain the fire. That is a big thing. You have to keep, you know, the firewood always dry. Even in rainy season or cold season, the firewood must be available. So all those preparations are required. Therefore, Agnihotra is not an easy thing. In modern days now, how many people follow Agnihotra? Hardly few. But there are people. There are people who follow, who strictly observe this karma, Agnihotra. They do daily this particular karma they do, Agnihotra. That is why some people, you will see that they will have the name Agnihotri. The name will end with, it's a title given to them, Agnihotri. So they do daily karma. This is a Nitya karma, daily karma. Compulsory action they must do, Agnihotra. And the same fire will be used for the cremation also, their cremation. The fire is preserved from the marriage to the cremate burial ground. But the ritual is not a big ritual. Only two agutis in the morning and two agutis in the evening. But maintaining the fire is a big thing. It's a vrata. It's a compulsory activity. So that Agnihotra he does. Okay, why he must do? Because it is a Nitya karma. Compulsory action, as the Veda prescribes, one must do. And also, the phalam of Agnihotra is Swarga, Swarga Loka Prakti. As I said before, in Veda, if there is no pala directly mentioned, you can always take it as the phalam to be Swarga Loka Prakti. It's a blanket rule, Swarga Loka Prakti. So, in the beginning, the person does the Agnihotra karma. karma he does with the expectation, with the desire for the result, with the desire for the result of the action. So he does Agnihotra karma to gain Swarga, Swarga Loka Prapti. It is karma. That is why the line you can see, Swarga Adi Kamartinaha, it is there. Swarga Adi, Swarga etc. It could be a Paraloka Sukham, Swarga Adi, or it could be a Igaloka Sukham also. Because Agnihotra Adi, Agnihotra etc. Other karmas, whether it is Nitya Karma, Naimittika Karma, what are Vidhi Karma, or Kamya Karma, any karma. Any karma is done for the enjoyment of the sukham either in this loka or in the paraloka. Iha or amutra, swargadi, swarga, etc. Who does kamartinaha? Kamartinaha. Artinaha is the one who seeks, seekers. Kamanam artinaha. The one who seeks what? Kama, desire. Kama is object. That is objects of desire. The one who seeks the objects of desire, and the objects of desire is swarga, etc. For that, he does Agnihotra adi karma, Agnihotra, etc. karma he does. So, therefore, the desire to do Agnihotra adi karma is to gain the result of attaining the swarga loka, etc. So, that was the desire for that is a desire for the person doing the Agnihotra karma. Therefore, they are kamarthis. Kamarthis, they are the seekers of kama, desire, that is objects of desire, the seekers of gaining the objects of desire, kamarthi. Therefore, he takes up the Agnihotra adi karma, and also being a nitya karma, he observes. Okay, therefore. That Agni is, he maintains, that Agni is called Ahita Agni. That Agni is called Ahita Agni. Ahitaha Agnihi Ahita Agni. Ahita Agni. So, Agnihotra adi karma lakshana dharma anushthanaya. Agnihotra adi karma lakshana. Karma lakshana, another part of Veda is that kama sadhana. Agnihotra adi etc. They are the sadhana, the means for gaining the desired objects, and therefore anushtanaya, for the observance of those means which are meant for gaining the desired objects. It is ahitagnehe kamye eva agnihotra ado pravrtasya. So for the person who is engaged in doing the agnihotra adi karma with the desire. With the desire to gain the desired object, the object would be swarga, etc. Pravrtasya, tasya, for the person, sami krute vinishte api. Sami krute vinishte. In between. Sami krute is halfway, half finished. In between. In between, what happens? Kame vinishte. In between, is desire, vinashte, is desire to go to Swarga Loka or to gain any Kama Purusharthu. Vinashte, it disappears, it is destroyed. It means, in the beginning he was a Kamarthi. He was after gaining the desire, the objects of desire. Now what happens, he probably understood the limitations of the Kama Purushartha. All the Purusharthas he has understood the limitations. They are not Nitya. It is not going to give him the permanent Sukham. It is not going to give them security. It is not going to give them the peace, the Shanti. So he has understood the limitations of the Purushartha, other Purushartha, Dharma, Artha, Kama. So therefore, the desire to gain the Swarga, etc., in between, it disappears for the person. For the person who was doing the karma, in between, the desire to accomplish this Swarga, etc., it disappears. Now he has become a matured person, a grown-up person. But still, he must continue doing the karma. Agnihotra karma, Agnihotra adi karma, he must do. Why? Because it is ordained by the Shastram, Vaidika Karma. It must, this, there is no choice. There is no option for, there is no option available in the Shastram not to do the Nitya Karma. Nitya means it must be done. Kartavyam Karma. Therefore, now the desire for gaining the Swarga, etc. is not there through this Agnivatradi Karma. But it is a Nitya Karma, therefore is still does the karma. Tadeva Agnihotradi Anutrishtataha Api. But he still continues to do the Agnihotradi Karma. Anushtitaha Api. Though he continues to do the Agnihotradi Karma, then that karma, that Agnihotradi Karma, we cannot call it as a Kamya Karma. We cannot call it as a Kamya Agnihotradi Karma. Previously, the same ritual Agnihotradi Karma, what he was observing was Kamya Karma. Kamya Karma is karma which is done to gain the desired result, the desired object. Kama is the, therefore, he does karma. That is called Kamya Karma. But now, that kama, the desire, is not there. It has vanished. He has become a matured person now. Therefore, the same Agnihotradi Karma, what he does now, after the disappearance of the desire for gaining the objects of desire, kama, it's not there now. You cannot call it as a Kamya Agnihotradi Karma. Therefore, the same ritual what he was doing before, now it is the ritual, it becomes the means for gaining moksha. It is not a Kamya Agnihotradi Karma. It becomes a sadhanam for moksha. Moksha praptaye sadhanam bhavati. Indirectly, it gives certain, it gives purity of mind, it gives sadhana chatushtaya sampatti, and also it is a nitya karma. Therefore, he observes the Agnihotradi Karma. Agnihotradi means otradi, adi, etc. means you can include all the panchamaha yajnas also. All the panchamaka yajnas, we will discuss about that in detail in the third chapter of Bhagavan Krishna himself, we will say. That also, it's a nitya karma. Those karmas are not meant for any, not meant for gaining any kama anymore for that person, because it's grown up. Therefore, the point is, though the same karma is performed by the person, now it is not a kamya karma. In this same way, for jnani also, after gaining moksha, after gaining jnanam, he does karma, but that karma cannot be called, that karma cannot be called a karma, really speaking. It is only a semblance of karma, because the karma doesn't bind the person. So Bhagavad Pada here, he gives the example of Agnihotradi Karma and dismisses the view of the Purva Pakshi. I hope you understand well. Yatacha Swargadi Kamartinaha Agnihotradi Karma Lakshana Dharma Anushtanaya Agitagnehe Kamye. So in the beginning, Agnihotradi Karma, that the Agni which was kindled and maintained by the person, that is, it's called Kamya Karma. Kamye eva Agnihotrado Pravrtasya, Agnihotra, etc. The Pravrtasya for the person who is engaged in that action, which is the means for gaining the Swargadi, etc. Swargadi Kama. Now, Sami Krite, in between, Pinashte Kame, when the Kama, when the desire for gaining the Swarga, etc. disappears, Tad Eva Agnihotradi Anutishtataha Api. Even though he observes, he continues to follow the Agnihotradi Karma, Tad Na Kamya Agnihotradi Bhavati. That will not become a Kamya Agnihotra. It is a Nishkamya Agnihotra only. Because that karma, what he does, it's only for chitta shuddhi. That becomes a sadhanam for the next step, which is jnana, jnana prapti. Jnana praptaye chitta shuddhi. Therefore, that Agnihotra, it doesn't become the means for gaining the objects of desire, whereas now the role of the same karma changes. In the beginning, you will say, Mamopatha samastha gurita kshedvara. Then you will say, Sargadi kama sarga praptiye iti. But now, is sankalpa is changes now. His sankalpa is Parameshwara prityartam moksha praptiye, jnana praptiye, aham agnihotradi karma, agnihotradi karma anushtanam karishye iti. The sankalpa changes because of the change in sankalpa, because of the understanding. Therefore, the karma will not remain, will not be the same karma as it was before. That is the argument of Bhagavad-pada. So Bhagavad-pada gives the same karma, taking karma as the example, and presents the karma kantis and dismisses the jnana karma samuchaya, that view, that jnana karma samuchaya, but these views was destroyed, dismissed by the Bhagavad-pada. Tata, next line we can read. Tata cha darshayati Bhagavan.
Tata cha darshayati Bhagavan.
Kurvannapi na lipyate.
Kurvannapi na lipyate.
Na karobi na lipyate.
Na karobi na lipyate.
Iti tatra tatra.
Iti tatra tatra.
Tatacha darshayati Bhagavan. Bhagavan Krishna himself darshayati. He shows this point. What point? That jnana, that is a jnani, he still does karma, but that karma doesn't touch him. That karma doesn't have any impact on him. It doesn't create any dent on the person. The karma is not done for the sake of karma pala, therefore it is not a karma. Therefore kurvanabhi na lipyate. It doesn't taint. Kurvan api, though he does karma, who jnani, kurvan api na lipyate. Bhagavad-pada he quotes in the 5th chapter, 7th shloka. 5th chapter, 7th shloka, it says that kurvan api, yoga yukto vishuddhatma, vijitatma jitendriyaha, sarva bhutatma bhutatma, Kurvannapi na lipyate. He is a Vishuddhatma. He is Vijitatma, Jitendriya, the one who has mastered all the sense organs. And he is Sarvabhutatma Bhutatma. He is the being in all the beings. He resides in all the beings. So that person, who is that person? Jnani. Though he does karma, Kurvannapi na lipyate, karma pala will not taint him. So therefore, the karma of the person is not a karma at all. And another quote also is from the same Gita itself. What is that? 13th chapter, 31st shloka. Na karomi na lipyate iti. Anaditva nirgunatvat paramatmaya paramatma avyayaha paramatma ayam avyayaha sharirastopi kaunteya na karomi na karoti, na lipyate. Sharirastaha api, though he is stationed, is placed, shariram asti, sharire tishtati, though he is there in the body, though he is, operates from this body mind sense complex, ekompeya, he is paramatma, ayam avyayaha. Paramatma ayam avyayaha anaditvat nirgunatvat. There is no guna, nirguna, and anadi. That is Paramatma. He is now identified with aham brahma asmi, aham sarvam idam. Iti, that jnanam is there for the person, though he is a sharirastaha, though he is stationed, operates from this body mind sense complex, but the karma of the person will not affect him. Na karoti, he doesn't do karma, though he operates from this body, mind, sense complex. Na karoti, na karma karoti, he doesn't do karma, and therefore karma pala na lipyate. Karma pala will not touch him. Iti
Bhagavad-Pada, he quotes the Gita itself. This is the way the argument is established. You have to give the quote. You have to quote from the Shastram. Shastram being a Pramanam, quoting from the Shastram and proving the point, substantiating the point and dismissing the opponent's view. That is the way. That is where the argument must be presented. In the tradition, that is how it is presented. Always you will find the quote from the Upanishads, quote from the Gita, sometimes quote from the Puranam also. Puranam also can be taken as the Pramanam. So the Bhagavad-Pada, he quotes from the Gita itself. Previously we saw he quoted from the Upanishad and all. Now he quotes from the Gita. Therefore, when we study those shloka from the Gita, we understand. The beginning itself, he presents the viewpoint so clearly, so that when we read those shlokas, we will not be taken over by the other views. So, therefore, the final conclusion is, for jnanam, there is no samuchaya. For moksha, there is no samuchaya. Jnanena eva mokshaha. For moksha, there is no samuchaya. Jnanam, jnana karma samuchaya is not possible. Na samuchyate iti our siddhanta. This is our siddhanta. You can stop here. We'll continue. Some more. Another few lines are there to start the first part of the Upadesha. We will cover slowly. Probably in another two or three classes, we will be able to start the 11th shloka of the second chapter from where the Upadesha starts. And stop here. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.
Thank you, Guruji.
Thank you, Ji.
Thank you.